join here this lecture with us. Welcome back on All Aboard's revision lecture series, and we are revising the GA part for RBA Grade B phase 1 of the examination, and today we'll be taking up February month current affairs. So we've already completed the current affairs starting from November till January. So if you have not gone through it, you can just quickly go back and revise the same. So if my voice is audible and if you are able to see the PPT very clearly, please give me a thumbs up so that we can move on to the lecture without wasting any time. Guys, quickly let me know this. Yes. Very good evening, everyone. Yes, I am just glad that you all responded. Moving towards today's quote. And the quote for the day is this: success usually comes to those who are too busy to be looking for it. Henry David Thoreau. Easier said than done, but it is very, very true. So those who are really busy working for things, I'm sure it is success then is going to follow them. Not for those who are going to keep on looking for it, right? We should probably develop that attitude of working continuously, and that's when you can see that success is going to naturally follow us. Yes, so easier said than done, but we have to definitely incorporate. With only few days left for the RBA Grade B exam, remember that you've put a lot of effort for these days, and now it is not the time to think whether you are going to be successful or you're not going to be successful, right? The time is to continue working. All the while you've been busy working, continue the same, and I'm sure it will follow you one day. Success is going to follow us one day, right? So thanks to Henry David Thoreau for today's quote. Moving forward, yes, thank you so much, Monish Sharma, for saying that these videos have been really helpful. I'm really glad that it has been for use. So with today's lecture, I think we'll be completing the most important month current affairs, that is February, which is the recent month, right? So we'll take up again 40 questions in today's class. So I would request all of you to be really participative and quick enough in answering these questions. Let's get started with the very first question of the day. The International Cricket Council has announced Indian edutech company Byju's as its global partner till which of the following years? A. 2021, 2022, 24, 23, 25. So can we have the answers very quickly? Recently, ICC has announced that Byju's is going to be its global partner, but till what year? So this is a kind of a easy come difficult question. We all expect that if the question is who's going to be the partner, I'm sure every one of you would have answered it very quickly. I just wanted to flip around here. It is going to be there for 3 years till 2024. So ICC said that Byju's will be its global partner for the next 3 years till 2024, right? The answer is 2023. The answer is 2023. For the coming 3 years, it's going to be the partner. Yes, the answer is 2023. Yes, it is option B. Moving forward, Andhra Pradesh State Election Commissioner N. Ramesh Kumar launched the eWatch app to receive the complaints related to the poll-related irregularities. This was done in collaboration with each of the following companies: A. Reliance Jio, B. Microsoft, C. Airtel, D. Google, E. None of the above. What is the answer? So recently, Andhra Pradesh State Election Commission has come up for this. So let me tell you that this can be helpful for any GA section of ECGC or other exams also. Do not have to worry about this because this is general awareness, isn't it? It's not going to phase 2. This phase 1 of RBA Grade B, so it is open. So some of the answers being guessed here. Airtel, yes, the answer is A, Reliance Jio. The correct option is A, Reliance Jio. So along with Reliance Jio, Andhra Pradesh State Election Commission has launched this eWatch app wherein they are trying to receive the poll-related irregularities from the people. But why is this important now is that recently Andhra Pradesh High Court has kept this app usage under hold. Why? Because already there are a lot of applications that are developed by the Central Election Commission itself, like eVigil. So since the popularity of the app is not that much, they wanted to restrain it from using for the current ports, right, in Andhra Pradesh. So that is the reason I think, since the High Court has given a judgment, you might have a question on that lines. Moving forward, Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal has taken a decision to appoint World Championship Sprinter Dash as the DSP in the state. So this is a very easy question for all of you, I guess. So who was recently appointed as the DSP in the state? So this is going to be beneficial for your GA section, means. Yes, it is Hima Das, who was recently appointed as the Deputy Superintendent of Police in the states, right? So there are so many laurels to Hima Das. She is world famous sprinter, and she has also got gold in the last medal ceremony, right? So moving forward, India's first digital university was inaugurated in which of the following states? Assam, Delhi, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. The options are a little bit confusing, but I'm sure you will be able to guess it if you've gone through the current affairs. So, which state is getting this first digital university? If you've not read through, I'm sure it is going to be a difficult guess, because we've got Andhra Pradesh, we've got Delhi. Probably there is a chance for getting confused. What is the answer, guys? Which state has come up with this first digital university? Great, many of you giving the right answers. Beautiful. The answer is D, Kerala. So India's first digital university is coming in Kerala. So this is one very, very important current affairs, right? So we might not expect, provided you're not reading it, there is not it is not possible for us to guess, because we have states like Andhra Pradesh, which are very, very proactive in digital governance initiatives, and also we have Delhi doing the same. So moving forward, the Union Cabinet has approved the signing of CECPA, that is Comprehensive Economic Cooperation and Partnership Agreement between India and two of the following countries. Very, very important. So this is a kind of FTA, right? Free trade agreement. So free trade agreements has got a lot of variance based on what all items are covered and the closeness of the cooperation. And so recently, cabinet has given approval for this FTA, which is now called as CECPA, between India and which of the following country? Maldives, Singapore, Israel, Mauritius, and Australia. Great job, it is Mauritius. So recently, India has signed an FTA, which is by the name, you can remember that it is Comprehensive Economic Cooperation and Partnership Agreement, right? So remember the abbreviation also, because you might be sometimes asked on these lines also. So it is very remote, but be prepared for that too. It is Mauritius, India and Mauritius going up for CECPA. According to Budget 2021, Ujjwala scheme has been extended to how many more districts? So some options here. So this is from budget directly. Ujjwala scheme has been extended to how many more districts? 210, 160, 100, 150, and none of the above. What is the answer, guys? Great. Yes, it is 160. Ujjwala scheme has been extended to 160 more districts, right? The answer is B. So this is a pick from the budget. Moving forward, which of the following players have won gold in Asian Online Shooting Championship? A. Saurabh Chaudhary, B. Divyansh Singh Panwar, C. Kyan Chinai, D. Rajeshwar Kumari, Rajeshwari Kumari, and E, all of the above. So, which of the following players have won gold recently in this Asian Online Shooting Championship? I'm sure this is going to be a little bit simpler question. So, the answer is yes, it is E, all of the above. All of the players have won gold in Asian Online Shooting Championship. So, recently, Asian Online Shooting Championship was hosted by Kuwait. Remember, it was Kuwait Shooting Federation which has hosted this championship in the year 2021, and it is one of the most important things to remember about, because after lockdown, this has been the first competition for the Indian shooters, right? And as you can see, all of them, Saurabh Chaudhary, Divyansh Singh Panwar, Kyan Chinai, Rajeshwari Kumari, all of them have received gold. We have four golds coming from this. Moving forward, CBIC has exempted several service providers, including banks, financial institutions, and exports, from using dynamic quick response or QR code on invoices to customers by companies having aggregate turnover of how many crores. So now this exemption has come from CBIC, that is Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, has now exempted these providers on using this QR code as a part of their invoices for their consumers. But how much should be the turnover according to this new change or exemption? The answer is D, 500 crores, guys. So the exemption that is given is for those banks, those financial institutions which will have a turnover of more than 500 crores, and also those export countries. The answer is D, 500 crores. So these all entities will be exempted from giving a QR code. The answer is 500 crores. Please remember this. So going forward, they don't have to provide the QR codes on the electronic invoices. So who are mandated? Only those suppliers who are going through the e-commerce portal. Here we can see that banks and financial institutions will not be going through the e-commerce portal. So they are exempted, and along with that, even exports are also exempted, because it is treated as a business to business supply. It is not directly treated to as a consumer supply, right? That is the reason you can also see that exports worth 500 crores turnover will also be exempted. Moving forward, a centrally sponsored scheme, namely National E-Governance Plan in Agriculture, was launched initially in which of the following years? 2016, 14, 13, 11, and 10. So what is the answer? So this centrally sponsored scheme, National E-Governance Plan in Agriculture, was launched in which of the following years? Yes, the answer is D, 2011. So this is an old scheme where it is trying to infuse technology into agriculture. So the Digital India was also penetrating. National E-Governance Plan in Agriculture was launched in the year 2011. The answer is D, 2011. So initially it was launched in the year 2011. Please make a note of it, right? Yes, the answer is D, 2011. Moving forward, Platform Scale for a Post-Pandemic World is a book that is written by who among the following? A. R.P. Gupta, B. Sangeet Paul Chowdhury, C. Meghna Pant, D. Hamid Ansari, and none of the above. So which of the following persons has written Platform for Scale? So what is the answer? I would like to tell Saurabh that failures are stepping stones for success. If you read the stories of successful people, we are not sure how many times they have been through the failure, right? Stay with all positivity. Look at what mistakes you have made. Try to correct the mistakes. Unless and until you are finding out what mistakes you have done and you try to avoid them and have a proper strategy, obviously, you're going to fail again, right? So ensure that you do not do it. So yes, great job, others. Sangeet Paul Chowdhury is the person who has written this book called Platform Scale for a Post-Pandemic World. Very, very good. And there's one important book by R.P. Gupta also written recently. How many of you can name his book, which is important, I feel? So R.P. Gupta has also recently launched his new book, right? And it is Turn Around India 2020, Surmounting the Past Legacy. So it is basically Turn Around India. That is what is the book of R.P. Gupta, which is also a kind of important book to remember. Turn Around India 2020. Right? Moving forward, on which of the following days is National Productivity Day celebrated? A. 2nd February, B. 23rd January, C. 12th February, D. 10th January, and E. 21st February. So what is the answer? Yes, the answer for this question is C, 12 February, right? So the National Productivity Day is celebrated on 12th February. Remember this, yes. And we know that 2nd February is also important for Wetlands Day. It is World Wetlands Day, right? So 2nd February is World Wetlands Day. And then what is the day? 21st February was also celebrated for the other important day. Can somebody name that? 21st February is celebrated as International Mother Language Day, right? So 21st February is also important. It is Mother Language Day, International Mother Language Day. It's not national. It is International Mother Language Day, right? So we'll move forward with the next question here. Who among the following will receive the CERAWeek Global Energy and Environment Leadership Award? Very important, and I'm sure it is pretty simple. Geetanjali Rao, Anand Kumar, Narendra Modi, our Prime Minister, Ratan Tata, Anjali Bharadwaj. What is the answer? So who has recently received CERAWeek Global Energy and Environmental Leadership Award? Yes, the answer is our Prime Minister Narendra Modi for all the efforts towards environment. He has recently received this Global Energy and Environmental Leadership Award from CERA. Right? So there is another important personality here who has received an important award. That is Anjali Bharadwaj. Can you quickly name what is the award that she has received? So Anjali Bharadwaj has also received some eminent award recently. Let me tell you that she is an RTA activist who has given a lot of contribution towards the legislation of RTI in India. So she has recently been honored with US Anti-Corruption Award, right? Yes, so the answer is US Anti-Corruption Award, and for this question it is C. Narendra Modi ji, right? Moving forward, India slipped two places to dash position in 2020 Democracy Index Global Ranking, 32nd, 53rd, 48th, 95th, none of the above. So what is India's rank in 2020 Democracy Index? So the answer is B. So India skipped by two places to 53rd rank in 2020. Earlier in 2019, it was at 51st rank, right? So Democracy India Index, we are faring poor with respect to the Democracy Index, and which is the institution that releases this? It is Economic Intelligence Unit, EIU, Economic Intelligence Unit, which releases the Democracy Index globally, and India's rank has been falling, and you can call it as one of the poor performers in democracy rankings, right? Moving forward, which state has become the first state in the country to make the end-to-end processing of cabinet paperless by implementing e-cabinet application? Karnataka, Arunachal Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Punjab. So which state became the first state in the country to make entire end-to-end processing of the cabinet paperless by implementing this e-cabinet application? So which is the state that has come up with that? The answer for this question is D, Himachal Pradesh. So it is Himachal Pradesh which became the first state in the country to make this end-to-end processing of the cabinet paperless, right? E-cabinet application. Very, very important. There is very high chance of this question being asked, guys. So it is Himachal Pradesh. Moving forward, Akhtar Ali has recently passed away in January. He was conferred the Arjuna Award in 2000 for his lifetime contribution to this sport. What is his professional sport? Cricket, tennis, hockey, kabaddi, and none of the above. So we have these kind of questions being asked generally. So to which sport did he contribute? The answer for this question, Akhtar Ali, who is the Arjuna Awardee, he has got this award for his lifetime contribution for tennis. So he's a tennis player. Please remember this. Very, very important. Akhtar Ali, he is related to tennis, right? Next question. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs approved recently construction of around 56,368 houses under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. So in which year was Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana basically launched? 2014, 15, 16, 17 and 18. So what is the year in which Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana was launched? So now recently, as a part of the current affairs, UFA, that is Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, have approved this construction of 56,000 houses around under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. So there are two components under it. And what is the year in which Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana has been started? It is बी 2015, राइट? सो दिस प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना, इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2015, एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन द रिसेंट पास्ट ऑल्सो दैट अंडर प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना ग्रामीण अराउंड 1.1 करोड़ हाउसेस हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड एज ऑफ जनवरी, राइट? एंड वी हैव द टारगेट ऑफ कंप्लीटिंग अराउंड 2.95 करोड़ हाउसेज विथ ऑल द एमिनिटीज बाय द ईयर 2022. दिस इज फॉर द ग्रामीण टारगेट बिकॉज ग्रामीण वॉज ऑल्सो इन न्यूज. सो कीपिंग द क्वेश्चन नेक्स्ट, यस, द एंशियंट कांचोत फेस्टिवल, विच इज अ सिंबल ऑफ एंशियंट नाग कल्चर, वॉज ऑब्जर्व विथ रिलीजियस फर्वर एंड गेटी अक्रॉस इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट. सो कंचोत फेस्टिवल वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट. सो इट इज अ सिंबल ऑफ एंशियंट नाग कल्चर. द आंसर इज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. आई जस्ट डिड अ मिस्टेक हियर. आई शुड हैव गिवन एन ऑप्शन एज नागालैंड हियर प्रोबेबली, विच शुड हैव केप्ट द क्वेश्चन लिटिल मोर डिफिकल्ट. आई वांटेड टू कीप इट, समहाउ इट स्किप्ड ऑफ फ्रॉम द आंसर्स. एनी हाउ द आंसर इज बी जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. सो कंचोत फेस्टिवल, विच इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ एंशियंट सिंबल ऑफ एंशियंट नाग कल्चर, इज वॉज रियल वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड रिसेंटली एज अ पार्ट ऑफ चेनाब वैली सेलिब्रेशन इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. Right, so this is a festival that is celebrated who by the followers of the Nag community, who believe that on this day, that is Lord Shiva and Parvati got married, right? And that is why they celebrate this. Moving forward, Government of India and which of the following international institutions recently signed an agreement worth $304 million to improve the power transmission network in Assam? World Bank, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, Asian Development Bank, New Development Bank, European Investment Bank. What is the answer for this question? So, Government of India has signed with which of the following banks? So, Asian Development Bank or Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank? The answer is C, Asian Development Bank. Yes. So, GOI, that is Government of India, and ADB has signed an agreement of how many millions? This is also very important. So, $304 million is the partnership worth $304 million, and it is mainly for improving the power transmission network in which states? It is again in Assam. All these are important facts that can be possibly asked as questions in the GA paper, right? February month is very, very important. Please cover it very exclusively. Next question, which of the following bank has recently launched this Namma Chennai Smart Card? It will facilitate various digital and retail payments in the greater Chennai corporation. So which bank has recently launched this Namma Chennai Smart Card, wherein you can use this card to make all the digital and retail payments? Great, great. Yes, it is ICICI Bank. Yes, absolutely. Good job. Moving forward, the board of directors of the Indian Broadcasting Foundation has appointed Dash, who is the former Chief Justice of Jammu and Kashmir High Court also, as the new chairperson of the Broadcasting Content Complaints Council, BCC, BCCC. What is the answer? Siddhartha Mohanty, Sanjeev Kumar, J.K. Shivan, Geeta Mittal and Soma Mundal. So Geeta Mittal will be taking the post of the chairperson of BCCC, and this is the first time that a woman is going to chair the BCCC body, right? Very important. It is a possibility for definitely being asked. So it is Geeta Mittal who is going to chair the Broadcasting Contents Complaints Council. And also remember, she has earlier served as the Chief Justice of Jammu and Kashmir High Court also. So this can also be asked, right? Yes. Yes, Soma Mondal is for sale. Absolutely correct. Okay, this was, I think, done already. So I am sure we are going to get the correct answer here. Dr. V. Shanta, world-renowned oncologist, has passed away recently in January. Her contribution to the field of oncology had earned her the Magsaysay Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan Awards. She belongs to which state? Delhi, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Tamil Nadu. So we did this already. Yes, great. So I'm not going to go deep into this. It is Tamil Nadu. Yes, Dr. V. Shanta is from Tamil Nadu. Moving forward, Indian Space Research Organization and Digital Mapping and Navigation Technology Solutions Provider, Map My India, announced a collaboration to launched an indigenous mapping portal and geospatial service. The geospatial portals will be called by which of the following names? A. Bhuvan, B. Vedas, C. Mosdak, A and B, all of the above. So what is the answer? Very important collaboration between ISRO and MapMyIndia, which is a navigation tech solutions company. The answer for this question is E, all of the above, guys. Yes, so it is named, you, it was alternatively named as all of these. The geospatial portals are named as also Bhuvan, Vedas and Mosdak. The answer is E, all of the above, right? Please note that for 22nd question, the correct answer is E. Bhuvan, Vedas and Mosdak. All of them are correct. It is all. Yes, all of them who have given E as the answer, good job. Moving forward, which of the following has received the Asia Environmental Enforcement Award 2020, awarded by United Nations Environmental Program? TERI, that is Tata Energy Research Institute. B is Wildlife Crime Control Bureau. C, Center for Science and Environment. D, Wildlife Trust of India. None of the above. What is the answer? So, which of the following agencies has recently received this Asia Environmental Enforcement Award 2020? Yes, Aniket, very good job. It is B, Wildlife Crime Control Bureau. Right? So, Wildlife Crime Control Bureau has recently got this award by the United Nations Environmental Program. So, you can expect questions like, which is the agency that gives this award? It is UNEP, right? Remember the agency also. Next question, COVID Performance Index, Deconstructing the Pandemic Responses, was recently released by Australia-based Lowy Institute. India was ranked at which of the following positions out of the 98 countries on the basis of its response towards tackling the pandemic? So this is not a common index that is released. Because of COVID, there might be a chance that this can be asked. So what is the answer? COVID Performance Index. What is India's ranking? 65, 73, 86 and 49. What is India's ranking according to this COVID Performance Index? Great job. It is 86. Yes. So do not think that we have done any better. Out of 98 countries, India is ranking at 86. In its response towards tackling the pandemic. Though our economic survey will not agree with this, we have to say that India's response is not being that steadfast, right? The answer is, yes, it is C86. Yeah. Next question, CREDAI, along with the following payments bank, started opening bank accounts for the construction workers. So CREDAI, along with which of the following payments bank, has started opening accounts for the construction workers? Airtel Payments Bank, IPPB, Fino Payments Bank, Jio Payments Bank, none of the above. So what is the answer here? Yes, great job, guys. It is IPPB, India Post Payments Bank, along with CREDAI. So remember, both the partners here, and both of them have started opening bank accounts, especially for the construction workers, right? You can have some kind of questions like this also in your GA paper. So be prepared for that. These kind of unique initiatives towards the marginalized sections. We have that as a part of the answer, isn't syllabus, right? So you might have questions on those lines also. Yes, great job for recollecting the chairman of the IPPB. It is Mr. Venkatramu. Great job, guys. So next question, which ministry announces eChhavni portal and mobile app that provides online civic services to residents of 62 cantonment boards? What is the ministry that has launched this eChhavni portal? Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, Ministry of Defense, Home Affairs, Information and Communication Technology, none of the above. So which ministry has launched? Yes. Great, great job. Yes, there's no confusion, only Ministry of Defense. Beautiful. So, cantonments boards are already here in the question itself. I'm sure this is going to give us a hint that is it is going to come under the Ministry of Defense, right? It is Ministry of Defense which has launched this eChhavni portal for providing civic services. Great. Yes, I purposefully gave Ministry of Home Affairs so that you might get confused, but a lot of you did not get confused, and that's absolutely brilliant. And those who got confused, no issues. Make this as a tool for proper revision. That's all right. Next question, which state government has introduced a unique 16-digit unique code to mark all kinds of land holdings? Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. So which state government has introduced this unique 16-digit unique code for marking? Yes, it is Uttar Pradesh. Fantastic. So you can remember, in case you do not know this, you can say that this unique code, it is unique. Unicode all standing starting with U. It is 16 digit coming from Uttar Pradesh, right? Next question, World Future Fuel Summit 2021 is a leading summit and exhibition which focuses on sustainable future fuel for the global climate change challenges. It is a summit which is organized by which of the following country? Germany, India, Saudi Arabia, Australia and Qatar. World Future Fuel Summit 2021. It's a leading summit and exhibition which is talking about sustainable fuels. Yes, right? Because it is about fuels, we might get confused. In case we've not done the current affairs, we might think that it is Saudi Arabia or probably Qatar who are really rich in the fuel reserves, right? But the answer is India. World Future Fuel Summit is a summit that is organized by India. Okay, moving forward. The World Sustainable Development Summit was held online from February 10 to February 12 by which of the following organization? So this was conducted by which of the following organization? World Sustainable Development Summit. Niti Aayog, TERI, World Bank, United Nations Environmental Program. So which of the following organization has conducted World Sustainable Development Summit? Great. Answers coming in. Yes, it is TERI, Tata Energy Research Institute, that is conducting this World Sustainable Development Summit from a very long time, right? It is TERI, which is the correct answer. And recently, it was conducted in the month of February between 10th and 12th online. Yes, it is TERI. Great job, guys. Next question, which of the following city has become the only city in India to be recognized as a tree city of the world by the Arbor Day Foundation and also Food and Agriculture Organizations of the United Nations. So which city from India has become the only city to get the status of tree city of the world? Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Thiruvananthapuram, Hyderabad and Bangalore. Yes, I can see most of you answering it correctly. Great job. It is Hyderabad. Yes. So remember the institutions which have released this tree city report also. So it is Arbor Day Foundation along with FAO, Food and Agriculture Organizations. Both the entities are also important, and it is Hyderabad which has got this unique status from India. No other city has actually got the status. We might think that it is Bangalore, but the answer is Hyderabad, tree city of the world. Next question, the government is planning to create at least 500 farmer producer organizations by the end of March 2021. The target is to facilitate rolling out of how many such bodies across the country by the financial year 2024. So what is the plan? Currently, as of 2021, 500 farmer producer organizations must be created. But what is the target to reach by the year 2024? 3,000, 5,000, 10,000, 7,000 and 15,000. Some of you giving the answers, and it is yes, see, 10,000 FPOs by the year 2024. It is very important after all the farmer protests happening in the country. Farmer producer organization is going to, which is like a voice for the farmers, will be an important point to have in current affairs, right? So government aims to create 500 such FPOs by the year 2021. March. So this itself is very important. You might be asked, by the year 2021, what is the target for the government of India? It is 500. By 24, it is 10,000. So remember all of these facts, which can be very important. Next question, which airport has received or achieved Airport Council of India's World's Voice of the Customer recognition, ACI's Voice of the Customer recognition? Kempegowda International Airport, Bangalore, Indira Gandhi International Airport, Delhi, Thiruvananthapuram International Airport, Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport, Chennai International Airport. So which airport has got this Voice of the Customer recognition recently? What is the answer? So which airport receives this Voice of the Customer? Yes, it is Kempegowda in Bangalore. Kempegowda International Airport for Voice of the Customer recognition, right? Next question, which of the following government passed an order for creating the fifth tiger reserve in the state and which is the 51st tiger reserve in the country? Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Manipur, and Jammu and Kashmir. So the 51st tiger reserve in the state country is coming from which state? This can be a very important question. So it is coming from which states, guys? It is from Tamil Nadu, yes. The answer for this question is B, Tamil Nadu, which has created its fifth tiger reserve. So this is the fifth tiger reserve for the state, and it is the 51st for the country. And it is Meghamalai Srivalipatur Tiger Reserve, right? So Meghamalai Srivalipatur Tiger Reserve is in which of the following states? You can expect question on these lines too. Tamil Nadu, Kerala, or Karnataka. Probably you may get confused between Tamil Nadu or Kerala, but the answer here is B, Tamil Nadu, right? So Meghamalai Srivalipatur Tiger Reserve has become the 51st tiger reserve in the country. Next question, which of the following will implement India's maiden geothermal field development project in Ladakh? So very important, geothermal field development project, NTPC, Adani Green Energy, ONGC, Power Grid Corporation, none of the above. So which of the following will implement India's maiden geothermal field development project in Ladakh? Yes, some of you already gave me the correct answer here. Yes, it is ONGC that has become the first in the country to implement this kind of geothermal field development project in Ladakh. So remember the place where it is coming up. ONGC is setting up this in Ladakh, right? We might get confused between NTPC also, but the answer is ONGC, right? Next question, which international organization recently released the Asia Pacific Personalized Health Index? Economic Intelligence Unit, World Bank, APEC, Asian Development Bank, Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation. APEC standing for Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation. D, Asian Development Bank. E, none of the above. So which organization has launched this Asia Pacific Personalized Health Index? Asia Pacific Personalized Health Index was launched by which of the following organizations? What is the answer, guys? Great. So we might get confused that it is probably Asia Pacific Economic Corporation or Asian Development Bank because we are talking about Asia Pacific Personalized Health Index. But the answer is Economic Intelligence Unit recently released this Asia Pacific Personalized Health Index. Can we have answers from some of you here? Which is that country which topped this Asia Pacific Personalized Health Index? And what is India's rank? Both of them. So which country topped this index? And also what is the rank of India in this index? Yes, India's rank was 10. Let me tell you that if you are assuming that there are around more than 100 countries, absolutely incorrect because it is only in Asia Pacific. So India is ranking 10 out of 11 countries. So that is India's rank, and the top first rank is going to, yes, like so many of you guessed, it is Singapore. Despite it being in 10th place, it is no good because there are only 11 countries that are being part of the Asia Pacific that were studied. Right. Next question, which state will host the second Khelo India University Games later this year? Chhattisgarh, Karnataka, Odisha, Bihar, Tamil Nadu. So which state is going to host 2021 Khelo India University Games? Yes, it is Karnataka, which is going to host the Khelo India University Games this year. Very, very good job. We are moving towards the completion. Let me see how many of you are going to quickly answer this. So, which of the following measures the activity status of an individual who has spent majority of the days out of the workforce but have worked for a short period of time? That is, say, for around 30 days. So, which of the following is going to measure that? Principal status, usual status, subsidiary status, A and C, none of the above. So, which of the following measures the activity status of those kind of individuals who where they're out of work most of the time, right? They spend majority of their days out of work, but they did work for some very short period of time. It is subsidiary status. Yes, all of you have given answer as C. Great job. So this was part of the economic survey 2021 this year. So very important. So all those who are not part of the workforce for the entire year, but probably they've worked more than 30 days, they are captured through subsidiary status, right? We know that usual status captures those who are employed for around a year. It's a long-term idea, right? If it is no idea, it's still fine. I wanted to just pick an economic survey question because you can expect some surprises here and there, right? So it is subsidiary status. Next question, the National Population Register is a register of usual residents of the country. It is prepared by which of the following ministry? Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Finance, Statistics and Program Implementation, Home Affairs, and none of the above. So which ministry prepares this NPR, that is National Population Register, which is going to have the data of all the usual residents? A usual resident is defined as those persons who have been resident of the country for around 6 months consecutively, right? Yes, I can see many of you answering it correctly, but in case there are some of you who are thinking it is statistics, but it is Ministry of Home Affairs. So census is also conducted by Ministry of Home Affairs. Remember that National Population Register, which is based on census data only, it is also conducted by Ministry of Home Affairs, right? Please remember the answer is D, Ministry of Home Affairs, that conducts the National Population Register. Next question, center integrates the trading system, integrates trading system with the agricultural services on the ENAM portal. So National Agricultural Market or ENAM is an online trading platform for the agricultural commodities in India, and this was launched in which of the following years? 2017, 2018, 19, 20 and 16. So ENAM, basically the question is asking about the year in which ENAM was launched. Some of you already coming up with the answers. Let me have a look at yes, the answer is 2016. All those who have given us 2016, good job. Yes, ENAM or E-National Agricultural Market was released or started in the year 2016 itself, right? And already there are so many APMCs which are part of this ENAM portal. Last question for the day. The mobile app Carbon Watch has been developed for the residents of which of the following city to assess their carbon footprint and steps in to reduce the carbon footprint in order to make the climate smart citizens, right? So we have a app called as Carbon Watch to make citizens of this state more climate smart. And what is that state? Bangalore, Delhi, Mumbai, Chandigarh and Panaji. So which state has got this Carbon Watch? Yes, there is a possibility of getting confused between probably Delhi and Chandigarh, both going for such kind of environmental friendly legislation. But the answer is D, Chandigarh. So the mobile app Carbon Watch was launched by the Chandigarh administration for assessing the carbon footprint and also to reduce the carbon footprint and thus making the citizens of Chandigarh more climate smart, right? Yes. So we are done with the 40 questions for the day, guys. Hope it was beneficial for all of you for having a quick revision of the February month current affairs, which I think will be the most important weightage for our GA section of the RBI Grade B examination, right? Thank you so much for being part of this lecture. I want every one of you to make a note that at our Olive Board, we have got this comprehensive courses for RBI Grade B. We have got full and mock tests, sectional tests, topic tests. You can use the coupon codes which can help you access these courses at very nominal prices. Have a great examination, guys. May God be with you throughout the examination, and may I see most of you for the phase 2 of the preparation also. Just stay calm, as you have already been preparing really hard for this, and all that it's going to require is not thinking about what is going to happen after the examination. Give your best, enjoy giving the examination, take care of your health, everything is going to fall in place, right? Thank you so much. If you have found the video useful, please hit the like button. And if you want to stay updated more with respect to the regulatory body examination process, subscribe to the Olive Board channel. Thank you so much. Happy learning experience for every one of you.